It is the front page of the Express and Echo, and also page 5. And it's a very detailed report on what was said during the meeting. So that it names the councillors speaking and the other people who spoke. And it complements the video I mentioned on the We Not Know show. Exeter City Council do post videos, but they don't explain very much. They've only got one camera from a corner of the room, and it's quite hard to make out who's the name of the person speaking. And at 2 hours 20 minutes, I think they could put a timeline in, so you could go to a particular bit. But maybe that will come later. The article's written by Ollie Heptonstall, who is a local democracy reporter, and it shows an email which is based at shows that she's based at Radio X, which is interesting. The other report I've seen online from Devon Live, it was based on Facebook, not so much on following the council meeting directly. So it's interesting how all these things fit together. The thing I noticed, having seen the video, there's a couple of aspects not really mentioned. One is the Ian Collinson, who's director of city development. One of the things he mentioned was urban edge. He thought the city centre design should be spread, so he liked the proposal as a gateway building, a statement of entrance into the city centre, and he thought buildings going right up to the pavement, right up to the edge, were a good way of communicating that. And I think that's an argument. I don't think we'll see that again. We may come back. Maybe the swimming pool that's been replaced, it's a bit closer to the city centre. Maybe that could be a gateway statement. But I don't think many people were convinced by that, judging from the later contributions. And I certainly think it's a complete contrast of styles. St Luke's is very well set back, with green space, lawn, shrubs, trees, and a cloister style. And I think it's completely different. And Waitrose seems to have followed a very different planning style at an earlier stage. So I guess there was a different planning idea when they were proposing their building. So I'm going to hang on to the idea that it's two contrasting styles, especially when you think last week on the front page that they're not using that photo this time, or artist's impression. It's from a different angle this week, so you can't see St Luke's at all. But last week they had a point of view from way back inside St Luke's, so it would appear that the green space that's actually part of St Luke's was the approach to this new building, and you couldn't see Heavitry Road, so that was different. But this urban edge idea, it may come back, but I don't think it fits with the sort of garden city idea. I think Exeter's going to be very, very spread out. Maybe within the range of the new DAB signal, and not all of it is going to be straight to the pavement. There's going to be quite a lot of green space and trees mixed up with it, and I think that's just as indicative of what the city is about in another sort of way. And the other thing that doesn't come across in the report is the various references to the university. speakers would say things like, well, why do we have all these students? Is it really necessary to have so much student accommodation? And the response seemed to be that there's nothing really Exeter City Council can do about it. The university decides to expand, and that's it, really. And I can't find, because I've been checking out YouTube and bits of social media and the Express and Echo. There is no statement from the university about what they think about it. And also there's nothing from St Luke's, which is very odd. There was quite clearly from the meeting representation from residents in Newtown and St Leonard's and a bit further afield as well, people concerned about it. But presumably there are people in St Luke's who either think it's completely necessary or are a bit worried about it in terms of the style of the local area. But there's no public... well, not that I've come across, anyway. If somebody knows of that, or somebody from St Luke's would like to send an MP3 or come in the studio at some point, that would be good. But I can't find anything. And also, something I'll come back to, I think, after I play another track, is the moving online thing, which I know I've raved on about, but I'm going to carry on going on about that because there's no response to it that I can find that's public anyway. If following the lockdown, more of learning moves online, what is the balance of investment in building and platforms that makes any sense? That's the question I'll come back to.